Hey, good morning everyone. It's G here, Gayon here. Good morning. It's Monday, July 30th, 2018. Woohoo! Welcome. Hope you guys had an awesome weekend. So today's health topic we'll be talking about, sharing this with the article, how to curb those wicked food cravings. If you get food cravings, give me your best emoji here right now. If you're watching the replay, do what I said. Give me your best emoji. I know I get those. I used to get those. The sweet cravings was my, oh my gosh. Like nighttime was my worst time, where I was, it's like a crackhead. You know, it's like I had to have sweets at night. I was looking for them. I was like, ooh. Anyways, I used to struggle with that. And thank goodness now my cravings are going away, because it's something I take to help me with my cravings. But anyways, so let's talk about how to curb those wicked food cravings. Woohoo. Okay, so here we go. Feeling snacky? The urge for something sweet or salty can hit you for lots of reasons. An afternoon lull, a light or early dinner, or even boredom. But you can do some things to get past it. Better yet, stop it before it starts. So let's see what they recommend here, okay? Number one, leave it at the store. If you know you're likely to give into a salty urge, don't let potato chips sneak into your grocery cart. Instead, stock up on unsalted or lightly salted walnuts. They have protein and omega-3 fatty acids that can be good for your heart. Same goes for a sweet tooth. Pick up some fresh strawberries or pineapple chunks and leave the ice cream in the freezer. So leave it at the store. Don't even bring it home, because the temptation. Drink water. It's a simple thing that can really help. If you drink more water, you're likely to eat less fat, sugar, and salt, just what you want to avoid in a snack. That is because what water helps fill in the space in your stomach, and that can make you feel more full. So drink more water. Stay busy. Boredom can lead to mindless eating. Call a friend, read a book, go bowling, anything to stop yourself from eating just because you don't have anything else to do. You could even go to a movie, but walk right past the popcorn to your seat. Woohoo! All right. Make it inconvenient. Put those cookies or chips in a small bowl across the room and put the bag back in the pantry. You have to get up each time if you want one, and that'll make you eat less. And it's not just the effort to get up that makes the difference. It's also because you have a chance to stop before you grab that next handful and ask yourself, do I really want any more? So make it inconvenient. I would just remove it entirely from my house. Don't have the cookies, the chips. Put healthy snacks only in your house. Popcorn, I do cottage cheese and peaches sometimes, you know. Put all the unhealthy stuff, don't put them in your pantry at home, because temptation. Reward yourself, but not with food. Make it something else you really like. Give yourself a prize for each small goal. For example, if you skip that late night ice cream on Friday, buy yourself some new nail polish on Saturday. Don't hold out for broader goals like eating better, okay? So reward yourself. Whenever you do good, you're able to, you know, fight the urge, and you did great. Reward yourself. Eat healthy. It's not just good for you. It can also actually make you snack less. Whole grains, vegetables, fruits, lean meats fill you up more easily and with fewer calories, and they take longer to digest, so energy gets to you in usable amounts throughout the day. Junk food dumps all the energy at once, and your body stores the extra as fat. This can leave you tired and hungry, even hangry soon after, which is true. Junk food don't satisfy you. So eat healthy. Exercise. This can serve as a distraction, and it may make you less likely to snack afterwards too. Research shows that a brisk 45-minute walk in the morning may help curb cravings and make you more active throughout the day. If walking is not your thing, try biking or swimming. So start exercising more. Eating healthy is going to definitely help you with those cravings. Stay away from triggers. A trigger is any situation that leads you to eating things on your naughty list. If you're not sure what yours are, keep a journal and look for patterns. For example, if you're often tempted at the bakery where you get your coffee in the morning, make your coffee at home or go somewhere else to get it. So stay away from the triggers, okay? The temptation. Mindful eating. This is paying attention when you eat to the flavor and feel of your food. Take small bites and chew them slowly. Ask yourself often if you feel full, and that can make you more likely to stop when you've had enough. a couple of other tricks. Eat with chopsticks or eat with the hand you don't normally do. So again, when you eat your food, experts say it should take you 20 minutes when you eat your food, when you sit down and have your meal. I'm talking about your main course meals, 20 minutes. So set your iPhone, your cell phone timers to 20 minutes. Time yourself 20 minutes. Give yourself time 20 minutes to eat that food. Drink water between your bites. That's going to help you feel full. And give yourself 20 minutes. So that way the stomach will have enough time to tell your brain you're full. If you eat too fast, then, you know, the thing is, you're not giving that stomach time to tell your brain you're full. And then you're gonna still feel like you're hungry, because the brain doesn't know you're full. So 20 minutes, guys, is ideally how long we should take. Plan your snacks. If you know you get hungry between meals, have the right snack handy. A good rule of thumb is 100 calories or fewer, and it helps if the foods have lots of water and fiber to fill you up. Measure them out and take a look. A medium apple has 95 calories, 20 grapes have 68, and a medium red pepper only has 37. So plan your snacks. You gotta plan your meals. That's why I need the MyFitnessPal app. Plan your meals. Plan your breakfast, lunch, dinner every day. I log mine in the MyFitnessPal every day. Plan your meals for the week. So that helps a lot. Brush your teeth. It may sound strange, but it makes you less likely to indulge. Why ruin that minty, clean, fresh taste in your mouth? Okay? I love these tips. Get support. Sometimes loneliness or anxiety can make you reach out for comfort food that's not good for you. When you feel a happening, call a friend first. It can lift your spirits and may help you get past the urge. Okay? Try not to stress. It can make you eat more, and it seems to make you want foods with lots of fat and sugar. In other words, lots of calories. The easiest fix is to stay out of stressful situations. Since that's not always possible, it can help to get plenty of sleep and exercise, including deep breathing or meditation. Whenever you're feeling stressed, you gotta walk away, take some time, go outside. If you're at work, go, you know, take some fresh air, listen to some music, do things that's gonna help you, you know, handle that stress better versus relying on foods, you know, the unhealthy foods to make you feel comfortable, you know, the comfort foods to make you feel better. Do other things. Go step outside, put some music on, get away, get some fresh air. Single servings. It may seem like a smart money choice to buy the supersized bag of potato chips, but it makes it harder to control what you eat. Smaller bags can fix that. If you can't resist a snack, at least you can keep track of how many calories you eat and balance them out. So, and I've heard this before, stay away from the supersized, guys, okay? So single serving is the goal here. Small portion size is important. And that's it. So you got some tips to help you with those wicked food cravings. And I know I used to get them a lot. Anyways, but I'm on the right path and losing weight now. I don't even have the sugar cravings anymore. So I know I'm definitely on the right path. Anyway, so if you want to be a part of my Eat Healthy group, I'm sharing tips, sharing recipes in there. All about eating healthy. I'm also, you know, I'm sharing with you weight loss tips as I'm losing weight. I'm also sharing what I'm doing, you know, to lose weight as well in that group. So if you want to join that group, just give me type in a yes here in the comment, or a one, whichever is easier, a one, the number one, or a yes in the comments, and I'll send you the information to join my eating healthy group. So that's the option for you if you want to lose some weight, you want to learn how to eat right, eat healthy. You're not sure how to get started, this is a great group for you to be a part of, you know, where I'm sharing tips daily to help you out. So a one, type in one, and the number one, or yes in the comments, and I'll send you the information to join our group. Anyways, that's my tip for today. I hope that helped. Share information with your friends and family. Have a fabulous Monday, guys. Stay cool, drink a lot of water. It's gonna be hot today. Stay cool, drink water, stay hydrated. Love you guys. Have a wonderful day. God bless. And I'll see you in my next health tip.